Here's a short little update on what I've all been up to over the last month with the Thunderbird. Everybody's been seeing videos on the Taurus. Well, I still have been working a little bit on the Thunderbird as well. It doesn't need as much work this year to get it ready for the Derby, but it still requires some. The engine is still sitting out of it, as you can see. And that is what I've been working on lately. If you remember, this engine had a hole in the oil pan from the last Derby. So I have been working on getting that fixed. Which is right here. If you can tell here, we need a pretty big repair to it. That big silver patch is all new metal added to this. What we did is, because there was already a rip in it, and we didn't want it to rub through again, this pan used to actually come out to about there and go down. What we did is we cut all that out and put our own patch in, so it completely removed this corner up there at the top. And now the steering for the 70 style car, it runs right through here. It won't be as close to the oil pan, and it won't rub through and rip a hole through it. Now it'll be sitting back here more. So this should be a lot safer method for our oil pan on this engine. But there's the new piece of metal on it, welded all the way around on the outside and inside. Inside is also welded. While it was welded, when it was all done, we filled the whole oil pan full of water to test it for leaks. And we had three real small pinholes, just barely any water coming through, but enough to notice. So I put JB Weld all across this top and the bottom part here. There's a leak there, there, and there. So it's completely sealed off. When I make sure it's dry enough here, it's pretty close to being dry now, I'm going to fill it all full of water again and test it to make sure there's no more leaks. Once I know it's good and it's not leaking anymore, then it will be going back on the engine, which needs a gasket to go along here and some sealant for those two curves. I can place it back on the bottom of the engine. Also, something very important I found out about this engine, which possibly could have saved this engine's life by having a hole in the oil pan. I removed the oil pan and decided to go ahead and clean out the oil pickup tube, which is right here. That pretty much connects to your oil pump and has a screen mesh on the end here, down in there. And that is what your oil gets sucked through from inside your oil pan. Well, when I actually took this off and looked at it, almost that entire hole there with the screen mesh inside was completely blocked shut. But all of this crap you see right here, yeah, that's chunks. That is not liquid. That is old pieces of the gasket that used to be part of the oil pan. And also, it looks like pieces of plastic, chunks of it, from, wow, if you go way back, I think maybe to my 2008 videos of our Derby season with the green Lincoln, back when it was mostly fresh, I took off the valve covers on the engine to put new gaskets on it and found a bunch of broken plastic pieces as well in that area. And that was from one of the airflow intakes on top had a plastic piece that hooked on it that was all broken apart. So whoever owned my Lincoln in the past must have had that break on them, and it fell into the valve covers, and they didn't think anything of it and dumped oil in there and washed all these plastic pieces into the oil pan. So combine that with pieces of cork and gasket from the oil pan gasket that had rotten off, and all of that got sucked up into the oil and was slowly plugging up that screen. So, like I said, that thing was almost completely plugged. Very close save for this engine. I'm sure during its last run, it wasn't getting the full amount of oil that it needed. So, good thing the engine didn't break the radiator and start overheating. We got lucky. Now, once I put this all together, should help a lot more on this engine with all that oil pulling through. Help it running better and cooler. So that's a short update of what I've all been doing on the engine for the Thunderbird. Also with the Thunderbird, because if you guys noticed during the derby with this car, I pretty much got pushed out of the arena 3 times in a row. And that is because this car had no working brakes at all. Something is wrong with the springs and the adjustments on here. So, that is getting all taken apart on the 9-inch axle, and all new springs and adjustments put in. When that's all put back together and we put on brake lines there, hopefully this car will have good working brakes. I only run rear brakes on my car because those are what spins, where the front wheels, they can stay spinning while I shift and not make a difference. I like to lock up my back wheels with the brakes whenever I change from forward to reverse so I don't snap the drive shaft or put hard strain on the transmission. Everybody has a different preference for running brakes. There's different strategies to front versus back and all four and everything else. Maybe I'll make a video discussing all the different ways people do the brakes on cars. So there's a lot to think about with strategy for doing that. It also depends your type of track you run, whether it's bigger, smaller, or muddy or dry. All that makes a difference. But yes, that's the main bulk of what we've been doing on the Thunderbird. We'll be fixing a few more bent bolts and such up front. We're going to test the radiator for leaks once the engine's back in. And then hopefully we'll get this thing running and pull it out of here and get a test drive. All my wiring is still hooked up inside. It just needs cleaned out from sitting all winter. There's a bunch of straw and dirt in there. So we'll do that. I believe there's still some gas. It's a sealed gas tank, so that should still be fine. No water has gotten in there. Then once we have this car running and driving again, we will start doing body work and framework on this whole rear end. We will be changing it some more than what it looks like right now. I want to make sure there's plenty of clearance out of the back window, and I want to make sure it's going to pack in just how I want it. So there you have it. More work being done on the Thunderbird, and hopefully seeing this thing running and driving before too much longer.